Hi, I'm Gary Mollahan, Marketing Manager for Airfloat. In this video, we'll be looking at how air-bearing technology can be used alongside mobile cranes to move a large, extremely heavy object. In this case, a 70,000-pound backup roll used in steel production had to be moved out of a warehouse and onto a flatbed trailer. The decision was made to use Airfloat air skids to float the backup roll outside the warehouse, and then a pair of mobile construction cranes to lift the roll onto the flatbed. But let's back up a moment and look at a few things in greater detail. First, you'll notice that the backup roll is resting on an improvised cradle made of tubular steel. That, as you might guess, is necessary to prevent the backup roll from rolling off the air skids. The cradle, in turn, is sitting on multiple steel air skids. The airlines are all attached to a single controller, allowing the air for all skids to be turned on and off and regulated simultaneously. The skids are all 20-inch steel air skids, each of which has a rated capacity of 8,250 pounds. There are 9 skids in the setup, giving the system a total capacity of more than 74,000 pounds. Total air consumption is 162 CFM at 60 PSI. Slightly complicating this move was the less than ideal transition from the smooth, trowel-finished shop floor to the rough, porous parking lot concrete. You'll notice there were some wide cracks and seams, which can channel the air away from air bearings and cause a loss of lift. There was also a slight difference in surface height, so a temporary platform was created to smooth this transition. First, sand was spread out and leveled, using stacks of washers and thin strips of metal as leveling guides. Then a piece of half-inch steel plate was laid on top of the sand, followed by a thin sheet of galvanized metal. Tape was applied to further smooth the transition and prevent slippage. Then it was time for the first part of the move. The air was turned on, lifting the 70,000-pound backup roll a few millimeters off the ground. Then it was easily pushed across the shop floor and onto the temporary platform. You'll notice that Airfloat air skids are self-braking. When the air is turned off, the air bearings deflate, gently lowering the load to the ground. The rest of the move was a fairly typical rigging application. A pair of link belt telescopic boom cranes were used, each with a 100-ton capacity. Nylon lifting straps were looped around each end, and the roll was carefully lifted off the ground. This may sound a bit self-serving, but this was the most hazardous part of the entire operation, in our opinion. The roll was about 10 to 12 feet off the ground at various times. The cranes had to move in concert with one another to keep the roll level, and multiple spotters were required. Again, let's compare that to the first phase of the move. The roll is inches off the ground as opposed to feet, and it's moved by human power alone instead of by mechanical means. About the worst thing that could happen would be for the air to suddenly cut off. But as we previously saw, that would just bring the backup roll to a gentle stop. And there you have it, a great example of how to incorporate air-bearing technology into your next move. Check this website often for more application ideas and other useful information. Goodbye.